Class 9. Today we are going to start with the chapter of supplementary reader in the kingdom of fools. So please open up your books as according to the new syllabus which is being sent by CBSE. We have to start with the chapter in the kingdom of fools for our, you can say, first term. So open up your books in the kingdom of fools. So by the time you open up your books, now let me explain little bit about the chapter. In the kingdom of fools, as the name of the chapter, it indicates that this is a story about a kingdom which is full of fools. So how it is full of fools? It means that the person who is leading the kingdom is fool, then ultimately all the inhabitants of that kingdom, they have to suffer. This is what has happened in the kingdom of fools. The king and the minister, they are actually fools. Why? Because they are not able to make the right decision and at the right time. So this chapter, it is about the indecisiveness. Indecisiveness means of the king as well as his ministers. So what is the meaning of indecisiveness? Indecisiveness means, it means when the person is not able to make the right decisions and quickly and at the right time. Or the inability of the person to make quick as well as right decisions. So it means that both the king as well as the minister, they were not able to make right decisions at the right time. Why they were not able? Because they, in order to make their kingdom different from others, what they have done, they have changed days into night and nights into day. It means that all the work which is being carried out during the day, for example, all the business, all household work, all the work in the farming, everything, it has to be done at night, and during the day people were sleeping. So what happened? The guru and his disciple, they have reached the kingdom. The guru, who is very wise, full of wisdom, so when he has realized that everything was just sold for a juju, that was quite funny because it is a humorous story. Everything was sold for very little amount, and moreover the people, they are sleeping during the day and they are working at night. He has come to know that this is a kingdom of fools. But the disciple, who was greedy in nature and who was, you can say, flattered by the availability of the different items at such a low price, he was fond of eating. So what happened to him? He was fascinated by this kingdom. He thought that this is really very wise to live here in this kingdom. But ultimately what happened? Because it was the kingdom of fools, so the disciple has to suffer. Because why he has to suffer? It is because of the reason that foolish people are unpredictable. Foolish people are unpredictable in nature. They are always unpredictable in nature, and how we have to use our wisdom but not arguments in order to tackle these kind of people. And ultimately you have to suffer at the hands of foolish. Ultimately you have to suffer when you encounter these kind of foolish people, because they are really unpredictable in nature. As they are unpredictable in nature, you won't be able to tackle them with your, you can say, with any other way. It is only your intelligence, it is only your wisdom that helps you to come out of that situation. So what happened when the guru and the disciple, they have come to this kingdom? Ultimately, the guru, he knew that it is not wise to stay here anymore because it is a kingdom of fools. But the disciple, who was fascinated by the various things that were sold for such a low price, he got so fascinated, so amazed by this idea to live here, that that he told the guru that he won't go along with him and he would stay there. And guru warned him, you don't know what will happen to you. And ultimately, this is what that has happened to him. He's going to be punished without committing any crime. So what happened? Why he is going to be punished if he has not committed any crime? This is the main thing of interest in the chapter. This we are going to read, that what will happen, okay, in this story. Of course, it is a very beautiful story, like you have read Happy Prince, how interesting it was, okay, and the moral lesson. Of course, Kingdom of Fools is also the same, or not the same kind of story, that was based upon the goodness of human beings. But this is based upon the use of wisdom, how to tackle foolish people and to be intelligent enough in order to tackle the problems, because it is only your presence of mind that help you to tackle those kind of problems, right? So this is what we are going to read in this chapter. So let us start with the chapter in the Kingdom of Fools. So page 1, which is being displayed in front of you. It is believed that fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can manage them. Who are the fools in the story and what happens to them? I have already given you an introduction that what has happened and how the disciple was able to come out of that situation in which he has put himself just because of his greed. Let us start with the story. In the Kingdom of Fools, both the king and the minister were idiots. See, the very first line has explained that in the Kingdom of Fools, both the king as well as the minister, they were idiots. Idiots means, actually, who is an idiot? You usually call this word, call to another person, you are an idiot. What is an idiot actually? Idiot is a person having zero IQ level. IQ means intelligence quotient. You know, in psychology, the intelligence of a person, it can be measured on a scale called intelligence quotient. So the person who is having zero intelligence, so this is called as an idiot. So see, the very first line, it highlights the quality of the king as well as the minister, that the ruling power was fool. They didn't want to run things like other kings. So they decided to change night into day and day into night. So what they want, they did not want their kingdom to be run like that of other persons. So what they have done, so in order to make their kingdom different from others, they have changed nights into days and days into nights. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night, till their fields and run their businesses only after dark, and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. This is the change they have brought. So what was the change that has been brought by the king as well as the minister in their kingdom? That they have changed days into nights and night into day. And before that, what they have done, they have ordered everyone that they will carry out all their businesses, their farming work, their household work during the night time. As the day broke, with the first ray of sun, everyone should be sleeping in their homes. So they have changed days into nights and nights into days. And anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death. Yes. And if anyone would be disobeying this order, is going against, no, this is wrong, then he would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for fear of death. So people who are bound to follow the orders of the king, why? Because of the fear of death, they won't be able to speak anything. They were feeling afraid. So ultimately they felt the fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. So king and minister, while discussing their matters of the kingdom, they thought, yes, this is really great. Why this is really great? Because we are successful. Why we are successful? That what order we have made, now all the people in our kingdom, they are following the order. It means that our project is successful. One day, a guru and the disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. So one day what happened, a guru and a disciple, they reached this kingdom. So you know, what is the nature of gurus? Gurus who are religious people, they never to stay at one place. They move from one place to another. They would never be staying at one place. So ultimately, finally, one day what happened, they reached this kingdom. It was broad daylight. But what was the strange thing there they found? It was that no one was around the city. It was, of course, a beautiful city. And everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring. There was complete silence. No one was seen around, not even the mouse. Stirring means moving. Not even a mouse could be seen moving. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. Even the cattle, they were also, you can say, sleeping by the day. So this is the change they have brought in their kingdom. They have tamed the cattle also to follow these orders. They were also sleeping. And the two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening. So the two strangers, who are the two strangers here? The guru and the disciple. They were amazed to see what has been happening around. They moved from one street to another, from one corner of the city towards the other, but nobody was awake there. There was complete silence. And then suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. But with the setting of the sun, or with the, you can say, when it was covered with dark, so slowly and gradually what happened? People started coming out of their homes and they were going on and shops are going to be open. They were going on their business. So what was that? They were surprised to see this thing. The two men were hungry because they were moving throughout the day and they did not find anything to eat. So they were hungry. Now that the shops were open, they went to buy some groceries. So now what happened? The shops were open. They thought that in order to eat something, we have to purchase some groceries in order to cook food. To their astonishment, what is astonishment means? Surprise. They found that everything cost the same, a single dudu. Whether they brought a measure of rice or a bunch of bananas. So what happened? What they came to know that everything was same for the same price, whether they have to purchase a kg of rice or they have to purchase a dozen of bananas. Everything was sold for the same price. Why? Because there were not set parameters for exchange of money. Everything was sold for one dudu. That is, again, very funny to hear. Okay? So, it cost a dudu. The guru and his disciple, they were delighted. They were surprised to see this, that why it is there that in the kingdom, everything is sold for one dudu. What is this dudu? They were amazed to see this. They had never heard of anything like this. They would buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. So finally, they said, we have never seen this kind of kingdom. And everything is sold for such a low price. So what they wanted, they thought that now we are able to get everything just for a rupee. How strange it is. The two men were hungry. Now that the shops were open and they went to buy some groceries. So this we have read, sorry. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools and wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. So the guru, who is very wise person, he has come to know when they have cooked their food and had eaten the food by conversating with other people, by their dialogue exchange with the other people and that of the kingdom, he has come to know that this is not a right place to live, because it is a kingdom of fools. Why it is a kingdom of fools? Because they have changed days into nights and nights into days. This is no place for us. Let's go, he said to his disciple. He told his disciple that it is not wise to live here. So it is better that we should leave this place and go to some other place. Everything was cheap there. All he wanted, but the disciple, he thought, no, I don't want to leave this place. Why? Because he thought that everything is sold for such a low price. And Guruji, where we will find this kind of place? We don't have to spend much money. And as we don't have much money, so it is really very good idea to stay here. I don't think so that we will go somewhere else. All he wanted was good, cheap food. Why he thought that this is the right place? Because he thought that everything is sold for such a good price, for such a low price. And he thought that it's of course a perfect idea to stay here in the kingdom. See, this is your vision that matters. The guru, who is having wide vision, he's just looking at the consequences. Okay, that what will be the consequences of staying there, because it is a kingdom of fools, right? But in case of the disciple, who is short-sighted, who is not far-sighted, he is not looking towards the consequences. He is thinking only about his present, that whatever he is getting is perfect for him and that is quite easier for him to live here. He has not seen, because every coin has two sides. If it has good perspectives, it can have the worst ones also. So he is looking only on the one side of the coin. He is not looking towards the darker perspective of staying here. Now, the guru said, they are all fools. This won't last very long. And you can't tell what they will do to you next. The guru said, no. It's not a right idea to stay here, disciple, because this is a kingdom of fools. And if we will stay here, you will never come to know what they will do to you. You will never come to know. But the disciple wouldn't listen to the guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. But the disciple, who was blinded by this idea of staying there, because everything was sold for one dudu and everything was so cheap, he thought, no, I don't want to go away from here. This is not a right idea. I want to stay here. The guru finally gave up and said, okay, do what you want. I'm going. So the guru, who was not able to convince the disciple, and he wanted that he should learn a lesson on his own, he thought, okay, it's fine. If you want to live here, go ahead. But I'm going to leave this place. And the disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas, ghee, rice, wheat, and grew fat like a street-side sacred bull. Street-side sacred bull means like street bulls hote na, healthy one. Like he has turned into a healthy man because he's eating a lot, because everything was so cheap. He's eating ghee, rice and all that full of fat. And ultimately he has turned out into a fat man. And this is the problem which is to be created. One night, one bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. See how the story is going to be changed here. But ultimately, it will came onto the disciple. See, one bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in. Sneaked in means to enter stealthily, to enter without getting noticed. And as he was carrying out his loot, the wall of the old house, it collapsed. See what happened? During bright day, why it is mentioned bright day? The robbery is being held during the night, during the bright day, because during the day, everyone was asleep. And bright day means almost afternoon time. During that, people are in deep sleep, sound sleep. So a thief, he has entered into a house without getting noticed. He was doing his loot, and ultimately what happens, that one of the wall of the house, it has fallen down, it has collapsed. And to add on to this is, it collapsed onto the thief, it fell onto the thief and collapsed on his head and killed him on the spot. Naturally, he was under such a great burden. What will happen to him? He was dead. His brother ran to the king and complained, "Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. This merchant is to blame. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for this injustice." See, his brother has gone to the king. He hasn't told the king that what my brother was doing. He said, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade means his long time followed business. He said the wall of the house, it has fallen down over him. He was dead. But it is the mistake of the owner of the house that he should have built a strong wall. If he should have built a strong wall, and now, as my brother is dead, you have to compensate the family for this. The king said, "Justice will be done. Don't worry." And at once summoned means call the owner of the house. The king, without inquiring that what business he was doing, he said, "Yes, of course, the justice will be done." And ultimately, in order to punish the person, he has called the owner of the house in order to inquire why you haven't built a strong wall. So see next. When the merchant arrived, the king questioned him, "What's your name?" "Such and such, your highness." He entered into the kingdom. He entered the court. The king asked, "What's your name?" He told his name. "Were you at home when the dead man burgled into your house?" He said, "You were there when that man entered to your house in order to loot you." See, the king is knowing, but still he was not taking action against the person who was a thief. He is asking the person who is the owner of the house that why your wall collapsed. "Yes, my lord, he broke in and the wall was weak. It fell on him." So the person who has come, he has simply told, "Yes, sir, this happened. He has come to my house. The wall collapsed and it fell on him." Now, the accused pleads guilty. He asked for guilty. He said, "Sir, this is not my mistake. Actually, it was wall that has fallen. So it's not my fault. Your wall killed this man's brother. You have murdered a man. We have to punish you." Now, the king said, "Your wall fell upon that man, this man's brother. This is your fault. You must have built a strong wall. And now we have to punish you." He was surprised. At one time, he is looting my house. He has come as a burglar. And now I'm going to be punished. What is my fault? He said, "Lord, I didn't put the wall. It's really the fault of the man who built the wall. And he didn't build it right. You should punish him." He said, "Sir, actually, it's not my fault why the wall has fallen." So he is a little bit intelligent. He said, "Sir, actually, the person who has built the wall, it is his mistake. He must have built the strong wall because the wall was not properly built. So this is the reason why I suffered from here." "Who is that?" King asked, Who is that man who has built the wall? My lord, this wall was built in my father's time. I know the man. He's an old man now and he lives nearby. In order to get rid of this punishment, he has passed on the crime onto the next person. This happens in the class also. When the teacher asks, yes, you have done this, the child will say, no, ma'am, he has done this. The next person will say, no, no, ma'am, that child has done this. Okay, so this is going to happen here. He says, sir, no, I haven't built the wall. Actually, it was built in my father's time, long ago. And he said, sir, I know the man. He's an old man. And he has turned out to be an old man. And he lives nearby. Now, the king sent out messengers to bring in the bricklayer who has built the wall, and they brought him tied hand and foot. So finally, the bricklayer was called. Bricklayer means the person who has built the wall. His hands, his foot, they were tied. They were called, they were brought to the court. You there, did you build this man's wall in his father's time? Now the king asked, hey you have built that wall during his father's time? He said, yes, my lord, I did, for he did not know that what crime he has done. What kind of a wall is this you built? It has fallen on a poor man and killed him. You have murdered him. We have to punish you by death. He said, what kind of this wall you have built? It has fallen on a poor man. And that poor man, who is that poor man? That thief. Is thief a poor man? No. It has fallen onto a poor man. He has been killed. And you are responsible for murdering him. And we have to punish you with death. The man was surprised. Before the king could order the execution. Execution means killing. Okay, deliberate killing. The poor bricklayer, he pleaded, please listen to me before you give your orders. It's true. I built this wall and it was a good. It was no good. But that was because my mind was not on it. He said, please, sir, please forgive me. Actually, I agree to this point that this wall was not built properly. But actually, it was not my fault. My mind was not properly working. He said, mind not properly working? What happened? So, I remember very well a dancing girl who was going up and down the street all day with her anklets jingling. And I couldn't keep my eyes on my mind in the wall I was building. You must get the dancing girl. I know where she lives. What he said, actually, sir, on that day when I was building the wall, there was a dancing girl who was going up and down the street. She was going up and down the street. This is the reason why I was not able to concentrate upon my work. And the wall was, you can say, wrongly built. You are right. The case deepens. King, how cool he is. Yes. Now, this is going to be a very deep case. We must look into it. It is not easy to judge such complicated cases. Let's get that dancer, wherever she is. So what he said, yes, now this matters, it is turning up in a serious one. Let us call that girl who's there. So the dancing girl, who has now turned into an old woman, she came trembling to the court. She was old, she was trembling, shivering. And she entered the court because she was called. Did you walk up and down the street many years ago while this poor man was building a wall? Did you see him? He said, many years ago, you were moving up and down the street when this man was building this wall. The old woman, she remembered a lot. She said, yes, my lord, I remember it very well. Now, she said, yes, I remembered it. So you did walk up and down with your anklets jingling. You were young and you distracted him. So he built a bad wall. So the king said, you are responsible for all this. because you have built a wrong wall. Why you have built a wrong wall? Why he has built a wrong wall? Because you were moving up and down the street with your jingling cantrips and he was distracted. So now in the next lecture, we will see that what is going to happen to that woman. This is all about for today, and tomorrow we will continue further. Okay. So by this time, I'm going to take the attendance.